Hey guys, how is it going? So, मैंने decide किया है कि I'll be doing these small YouTube videos about Liverpool as well, since Liverpool is the club that I support actually in EPL. So yeah, so as you know, August में we are gonna start with the new EPL season, 2017 season, and nearly all the teams in EPL have brought in some new players, which is why I think सबकी starting lineups obviously change होने वाली हैं. So I'll obviously be talking about my club Liverpool because we have made a lot of changes. We brought a lot of good players in, and some of them are gonna start and some of them are gonna be on the bench. So obviously I wanted to talk about the starting lineup, basically the starting lineup that I think is gonna do well in Premier League. So starting में I'll start from goalkeeper and I'll go up till the strikers. So the system that I'm working on is basically a 4-1-3-2 system. It will have two strikers up front. So starting from goalkeeper, I think Karius is obviously gonna start ahead of Mignolet because Mignolet had a shocking season. Last season he had some really shocking performances, and I personally think that we lost Europa because of Mignolet. And obviously the next person who's gonna come in, the person that I'm gonna talk about next, but like Mignolet had a shocking season and I don't see him continuing as the number one, at least not in starting. Maybe matlab bhagwan na kare, if Karius turns out to be even worse than him, then yeah, obviously he'll have to come back, but let's hope that does not happen. So as you can see, I have displayed the stats on the screen. You can see Karius is clearly much, much better than Mignolet. Secondly, let's move on to the left back spot. So now this is going to be a controversial decision, but the problem is we have already loaned out Brad Smith. Now Flanagan can obviously play on left, but Flanagan also is under consideration to leave out on either loan or a full transfer with a buyback clause. So very controversially, even though I do not like this player at all, I have to put Alberto Moreno in the left back spot. Now obviously we have been looking for a left back. We went after Chilwell, we went after I think it was Hector Jonas, but we haven't found our man yet. So if the current state of affair continues, we'll probably end up with Moreno starting at left back. Now he particularly did not have a really good season. He was at mistake for a couple of goals, and when I say a couple of goals, a lot of goals. He's clearly too attacking, always in the attacking half, does not track back a lot, and has given up silly penalties. Matlab, his challenges inside the box are childish. But that being said, he's really good offensively. He has worked on his crosses, so his crosses have become decent. And he does provide a goal-scoring outlet. So all in all, I don't think he's that bad. But yeah, he needs to really work on his defensive abilities. The second guy that... So now, obviously, the third guy is going to be your first centre-back. And this is one of the other guys that took a huge amount of criticism during basically the time of Brendan Rodgers, but now he has turned out to be a really, really solid performer. I'm obviously talking about Dejan Lovren. Lovren had a really bad start of the season under Rodgers, but then obviously Rodgers got sacked, Klopp came in, and Klopp worked his magic on Lovren. And the change in fortunes of Lovren, you can clearly see from the fact that how important he became to the team when he scored that winning goal against Dortmund. And obviously by the end he became our one of our first choice center backs along with Sakho, but then obviously Sakho got suspended, which brings me to my next pick, which is going to be Matip over Sakho, because Sakho clearly is not going to be up to the mark at the start of the season because he hasn't played matches and he's not match fit. Matip obviously performed really, really well during his season with Schalke last year, and a really good acquisition, I must say. Like, I'm really impressed with Matip. In right back, we'll have our usual stalwart, Nathaniel Clyne. Clyne has been absolutely rock solid at right back for the last couple of seasons, and I believe this is the best signing that we have made from Southampton till now, because I haven't seen Mane play in a Liverpool shirt yet. So obviously I'll be giving it to Clyne. Clyne has been our best signing from Southampton, closely followed by, I think, Adam Lallana. So in the defensive mid spot, I have Emre Can. Emre Can obviously is a no-brainer. The guy has grown tremendously in this role in the past few years. In the past 2 years, he has grown tremendously as a player. And he has been absolutely phenomenal in some games. And there are certain games when he goes missing or lacking. But he's obviously a young guy. He's gonna improve with age. And I personally think that he's gonna be the next Liverpool captain, because he has that sort of charisma and he has the ability to become an exceptional player. Now, moving on to the front three, essentially the winger, the center forward, and the right winger. So on left wing, obviously, I have Philippe Coutinho. Coutinho is basically one of the two best players that we have right now in our squad. And I would say we only have two world-class players right now in the squad, and one of them is obviously Philippe Coutinho. Now, I hope we keep hold of Coutinho during this summer window and don't let him go, because obviously without him, our squad is definitely not cut out to sort of make the top four. And Coutinho is obviously going to be a major influence on anything that Liverpool is going to do in the Premier League this year. At center forward, I obviously have Roberto Firmino. Firmino had an up and down season last year. There were matches where he goes missing, but then there are certain matches where he really performed well, like the Arsenal match. And obviously, he has a lot of quality. Under Klopp, he has improved a lot. And I do hope that he's going to have an exceptional season this season, essentially the breakout season that you can say, because he has the same amount of ability as Coutinho. And I am sure that if given enough time and enough space, he can be really deadly for Liverpool. Now, the right wing is where all the excitement lies, because on right wing, we have Sadio Mane. So obviously, I haven't seen Mane play a lot. I saw him once or twice when I was watching the Southampton matches. He has a lot of pace, but what troubles me is the fact that he can be extremely good in one match, and then he can kind of go invisible in the next one, which is something that has really bothered me a lot. But obviously, when he is good, he's really, really good. Now, the one player that is missing here that a lot of you will be questioning me for is Wijnaldum. Obviously, I have Wijnaldum on the bench, because as of now, I don't see any place where Wijnaldum can actually play in the squad. Because obviously, having three midfielders up front and with Can holding, I don't see Wijnaldum has any place. I still believe that Wijnaldum is not a big game player, and he is going to be very sort of mediocre at Liverpool. Because when I watched Newcastle last year, there were times where he completely went missing, looked disinterested. So he's not exactly a fighter, which is something that troubles me about Wijnaldum. And obviously, coming to the front two now, the front two, one pick is pretty obvious. It is obviously Daniel Sturridge. He's been a phenomenal striker for past 3 to 4 years. A really good buy from Chelsea. One that I rate very highly, and he's obviously the second world-class player that I was talking about that we have in our squad. The one thing about Sturridge is that he's not exactly the fittest of strikers, and he's very injury prone. So obviously you can fairly expect that at some point in the season he is gonna get injured, and we do have a good backup on the bench in Divock Origi. But now, coming to my second striker, and this can again be a little controversial for some people, because people rate Origi very highly, but I personally rate Danny Ings higher than Divock Origi, because Danny Ings obviously is a perfect Klopp type of player. He believes in pressing, he's very hardworking, he's very intelligent, and he knows how to take a goal. As you could see in the preseason matches, whenever he got a chance, he was able to score a goal, and that is something that Liverpool has been missing for some time. So I personally believe that Danny Ings should start up front.